Okay, good morning children. In yesterday's class we started with the new chapter, permutation and combination, isn't it? Permutation and combination means it is the study of selecting objects, arranging the objects and all. And there we started about with the principle of counting, isn't it? Principle of counting. Suppose there are two objects, suppose you can select the first object in two ways and select the other object in three ways. You can select the first object in two ways and the other object, second object in three ways. Total, how many ways you will be able to select? Yes, what is the answer, Pranav? First object you can select in two ways. Second object you can select in three ways. So combining these two, okay, how many ways are there you can select the number, the elements?
Multiplied.
That means you have to find 2 into 3. 2 into 3. So what is 2 into 3?
6.
6 ways. We can select it in 6 different ways. Yesterday we did some questions based on that. Is that no? Now look at these questions that we have discussed. Okay, listen children, look at here. Can you see this? Is it clear? Is the board visible, children? Is it okay? Okay, so look at here. Actually, this was introduced by the mathematician Jacob Bernoulli. He gave this concept. Fundamental principle. So in fundamental principle, what we learned, suppose you have first three pants and two shirts. Suppose we have three pants and two shirts, in how many ways we can wear? 6 into 2? 12 ways, isn't it? We'll be able to wear it in 12 different ways. Okay, so that principle only we call it as principle of counting. Okay, that principle we call it as principle of counting. Look at here. If an event occurs in m different ways, following which another event occurs in n different ways, then the total number of occurrence of the event is given by m by n. Then the total number of occurrence of the event is given by m by n. It is given as m by n. So, okay, now let us do the problems based on this. We are going to solve questions based on this. Write the question. How many four-letter words can be formed? Using the letters of the word rose. How many four-letter words can be formed using the letters of the word rose? Where the repetition of letters is not allowed. Repetition is not allowed. So how many letters are here in this word?
It is
a four-letter word. We want to frame a four-letter word. Okay, so this, suppose I denote this as 1, 2, 3, and 4. It is a four-letter word. So here, the first place, In the first place, we can fill it with how many ways? In how many ways we can fill?
Four ways.
Can be filled in four ways. We can fill it in four ways. Okay, suppose we used one letter here. Here it is said, no repetition. Repetition is not allowed. So the second place can be filled in how many ways?
Three ways.
Second letter we can fill it in three ways, isn't it? Because we have used one letter, so three more letters are left out. Now if you come on to the third place, so in the third place we can fill it in two ways, isn't it? We can fill this in two ways. And the fourth place we can fill it in one way. We can fill it in one way. Therefore, what is the total number? What is the total? It is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So what is the answer? 24 ways. So we can frame 24 letter words. Okay, we can frame 24 four letter words. Whether meaning is there or not there, it's not a matter. Okay, we can frame 24 words like this. Okay, is it clear, children? Shall we do the next one? Write the question. How many three digit numbers can be formed? How many three digit numbers can be formed from the digits? How many three-digit numbers can be formed using the digits? Can be formed using the digits? How many three-digit numbers can be formed using the digits? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Using the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And 5, if first case, repetition of the digits is not allowed. If repetition is not allowed, second one, repetition is allowed. First one, repetition is not allowed. Second one, repetition is allowed. look at your children. So how will you solve this? How you will be solving this? How many digits are given here? Tell me, how many digits are given?
Five
digits. Okay, we are given with five digits. The digits are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 are the given digits. Okay, so these are the given digits. Now let us consider the first case. First case, no repetition, isn't it? Repetition is not allowed. So we want to frame a three-digit number. Okay, when it is given a three number, we can usually start with ones place, tens place, hundreds place. Ones place, tens place, and hundreds place, isn't it? Now, look at here. So no repetition. So in how many ways we can fill the hundreds place? Hundreds place can be filled in how many ways? Hundreds place can be filled in how many ways?
Five
ways. Very good. What about the other children? Please turn on your video and answer the questions. So we have used one digit here, isn't it? We have used one place. We have filled the hundred. Now how many numbers will be left out? How many digits will be left out? Among the four numbers, we have used one digit here. So now how many digits will be left out?
Four.
So tens place can be filled in. We can fill it in four ways, isn't it? The tens place can be filled in four ways. And what about the ones place? Ones place can be filled in how many ways? Can be filled in?
Three ways.
So what is the total number? Total is 5 × 4 × 3. It is 60 ways. It is 60. Again, it is 60 ways. We can fill it in 60 ways. Okay, now look at the second case. What about the second case? Repetition is allowed, isn't it? Second case, what is given? Repetition is allowed. So if repetition is allowed, tell me, how will you fill the hundreds place? The repetition is allowed. We can repeat the same numbers again and again, isn't it? So if repetition is allowed, then how we can do this? In how many ways we can fill the hundreds place? In how many ways we can fill the hundreds place? Yes, tell me children, hundreds place can be filled in how many ways? hundreds place can be filled in 5 ways, isn't it? We can fill it with 5 ways. Similarly, tens place can be filled in 5 ways, because the same digit can be used. And what about the ones place? Ones place can be filled in 5 ways. So what is the total number of ways? What is the total? 125, because repetition is allowed. So repetition is allowed means in the second case we get the answer as 5 into 5 into 5, which is 125. 5 into 5 into 5, that is equivalent to 125. Okay. Next one. Write the next one. How many 3-digit even numbers? How many 3-digit even numbers can be formed? How many 3-digit even numbers can be formed? How many 3-digit even numbers can be formed? How many 3-digit even numbers can be formed from the digits? From the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If the digits can be repeated. If the digits can be repeated. If the digits can be repeated. So we are given with the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are asked to find how many 3-digit numbers can be formed, isn't it? We are asked to find how many 3-digit numbers, even numbers. How will you say the number? Okay. How will you fix a number is odd or even? How or when you will say the given number is odd or even? Suppose I am giving a number 55. Is it odd or even?
Odd.
Odd. How will you say it is odd? Why we are saying that it is odd? Yes, Abdulrahman.
Last number.
Very good. Last place. Units place. If the units place is filled with an even number, then we can say it is an even number. Isn't it? If the units place, if it is in the units place, you have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Units place is otherwise called ones place. If we get 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 in the ones place, then we can say it is an even number. Otherwise, it is called an odd number. Otherwise, it is called an odd number. Okay. So now the question is, we want to frame an even number. So we want to frame a 3-digit even number. So ones place, tens place, hundreds place. So now tell me how many ways we can, how many digits are there that we can fill it with ones place? Ones place can be filled in ones, otherwise we call it as units, can be filled in how many ways? Look at here, in the ones place, either we can use 2 or 4 or 6. Only these 3 now digits only we can use. We can't use 1 or we can't use 3 or 5. So ones place can be filled in 3 ways, isn't it? We can fill it in 3 ways. What about the tens place? How many ways you can fill? Yes. You can fill it in 6 ways because the repetition is allowed. So, okay, repetition is allowed. Repetition is allowed means the digit we are using in the ones place can be used in tens place also. Repetition is allowed. So we can use the digit again and again. So the tens place can be filled in 6 ways. And what about the hundreds place? That is also in 6 ways. Yes, correct. So hundreds place also can be filled in 6 ways. Therefore, what is the total? What is the total number of ways? Total ways is 6 into 6 into 3. Find out the answer. It is 108. Okay, is it clear? Is it okay? Yes, is it okay, Krishna Gandhi? Any doubt?
No.
No. Pavitra? Shall we move on to the next type? Next question? Yes, Aman, Vinay, finished? Write the next one. How many four-letter code? How many four-letter code? How many four-letter code can be formed? How many four-letter code can be formed using the first 10 digits? Sorry, not digits, using the first 10 alphabets. Using the first 10 alphabets. Using the first 10 alphabets. Using the first 10 alphabets in English. You are using the first 10 alphabets. You want to frame a four-letter code. So you want to frame a four-letter code. What is given? Is there anything given about repetition or something? Is it given? Nothing is given means we will take it as no repetition. Okay? If nothing is given means we take it as no repetition. Write it in the bracket. No repetition. Repetition is not allowed. Okay, so we want to frame a four-letter word. Repetition is not allowed. So, in how many ways you can fill the first place? Yes. First place we can fill it in 10 ways. Roseanne, how many ways we can fill the second place? In how many ways we can fill the second place? Yes, I think she left. No. Pavitra, how many ways we can fill the second place?
9.
Third place can be filled in 8 ways, isn't it? And the fourth place can be filled in 7 ways. Therefore, what is the total number? So total number of ways is multiply and write 7 into 8 into 9 into 10. Multiply this, you'll get the answer. What about the other children? Are you getting the same answer? Check your answer. Once again, you check your answer. 7 into 8 into 9 into 10, isn't it? 7 8s are 56. 56 into 90. 5040. Is it correct, Pavitra? Okay. Is it okay, children? This one is a easy one, isn't it? Huh? Do you, how you feel with this exact chapter? Is it a easy one or difficult one? Hmm? Is that no? Is it a easy one or not? Okay. Okay, just an easy one. Yeah, okay. Now write the next one. How many five digit telephone numbers? How many 5-digit telephone numbers can be constructed? Okay, nowadays we use 10 digits, 6 digits, 7 digits and all. If you take landline, 7 digits or 6 digits are there, isn't it? I think, okay, this was for given in, okay, during that time, only 6 digits or 5 digits were used in telephone. Now, write the question. How many 5-digit telephone numbers can be constructed using the digits? Using the digits 0 to 9. Using the digits 0 to 9 if using the digits 0 to 9 if each number, look at this, each number starts with 6, 7. Each number starts with, if each number starts with 6, 7 and no digit appears more than once. And no digit appears more than once. No digit appear more than once. Okay, look at the question. How many 5-digit telephone numbers can be constructed using the digits 0 to 9 if each number starts with 6, 7 and no digit appears more than once? How will you do this? No digit appear more than once. Okay, it is given. We want to frame a 5-digit number, isn't it? We want to frame a 5-digit number. So, 5-digit number we want to frame using the digits 1, 0 to 9, and all the numbers, all the phone numbers starts with 6, 7 and no digit is repeated. So tell me, how will you, in how many ways? Okay, I'm marking this as ones, tens, hundreds. Already these two places it is already filled. So we have to fill only the ones, tens and hundreds. So tell me, in how many ways you can fill the hundreds place? Hundreds place can be filled in how many ways?
10 ways.
Is it 10?
No.
Is it 9? How many digits we have used? Look at here, it is given. No digit appear more than once. Already we have used 2 digits, isn't it? 6 and 7 we have used. So how many is left out?
8.
So hundreds place can be filled in 8 ways. Then, what about tens place? Tens place can be filled in 7 ways. And ones place can be ones or units, both are same, okay? Ones place can be filled in 6 ways. So what will be the answer? Answer is 8 into 7 into 6. 8 into 7 into 6. What is the answer, Akshay?
336.
Is it correct, Roseanne?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Now write the next one. A coin is tossed 3 times. And the outcomes are recorded. How many possible outcomes are there? How many possible outcomes are there? What will be the answer? A coin is tossed 3 times. How many possible outcomes are there? What will be the answer? How many outcomes? Is it 2 outcomes? This one we have learned last year in probability. Yes, Krishnakanti. What is the answer?
2 outcomes.
One coin, if I throw one coin, we'll get 2 outcomes. Is that no? Which are the outcomes? You may get head or tail. If you throw 2 coins, what is the outcome? This one we have discussed last year. Both may be head, both may be tail, or tail, head, head, tail. If you throw 2 coins, these are the outcomes. Is that no? So if you throw 3 coins, what are the outcomes? What will be the outcome?
Man.
No, 2 cube, which is 8 outcomes. How many outcomes? Okay, 1 coin means 2 raised to 1, which is 2 outcome. 2 coin means it is 2 square, we will get 4 outcomes. For 3 coins, how many outcomes? 2 cube, which is 8. 4 coins means how many outcomes? How many outcomes will be there if you throw 4 coins? 2 raised to 4. Okay, if you throw 4 coins, the outcomes will be 2 raised to 4, which is 16 outcomes. It will be 2 raised to 4, which is 16. Now here we throw 3 coins. How many outcomes will be there? 8 outcomes. Okay. How can you write all the outcomes? What are the outcomes? All the 3 may be head. All the 3 may be tail. Or first one you can fix. First one may be head. The next 2 may be tail. Okay. Or tail, head, tail. Tail, tail, head. Or 2 may be head, H, H, T, H, T, H, T, H, H. We're getting 8 outcomes. So we get 8 outcomes. Okay, we will get 8 outcomes. Okay. Now we can do the next one. Write the next one. Given 5 flags of different colors. Given 5 flags of different colors. How many different signals can be generated? how many different signals can be generated if each signal requires the use of two flags. Each signal requires the use of two flags. Each signal requires the use of two flags, one below the other. Okay, we are given with five colors. We have five colors. We have to make a flag. Okay, in one flag, how many colors are needed? We use two different colors, isn't it? Look at the question. Given five flags of different colors, how many different signals can be generated if each signal requires two flags, one below the other? That means flags means, suppose you are given okay, suppose you are given say five colors like this. Okay, suppose you are given with five colors. Suppose you are given one green okay, so you are given with five colors. We want to frame a signal. A signal consists of, what is given? A signal consists of two colors. We can use two colors at a time, but the two colors must be different. Okay, we want to frame a signal and the signal consists of two colors. Okay, so suppose I am using two signals. So what about the topmost, top one? Top one, you can fill it with how many colors? Okay, imagine you are given with the small, small rectangular pieces like this. One is, okay, with five different colors. And one signal, for making one signal, we use two colors. We use two flags. So when you make the top one, when you select the color for the top one can be selected in how many ways? You need two color signal, isn't it? It can be selected in how many ways? No, it is in five ways. You can use any one of the colors, isn't it? So we can use the top one. Okay, five ways. What about the bottom one? Bottom one can be selected in one color already we have used, isn't it? So we can use four ways. Four colors will be left out. So how many signals we can make like this? So total number of signals is 5 × 4, which is 20. We can make 20 signals out of this. Okay. So, okay. Is the concept clear, children? Okay. Okay. Answer your attendance. Okay. With this, we end the session now. Okay. Thank you. We'll be learning more about in the next class. Okay.